The Sixers welcome back their big man, and Double Zero had another double-double in the first of two games with the Wizards.
And we do that as beautiful basketball.
Two straight wins for Bob. We'll explain the stark difference in the Flyers' goaltending numbers, and we're not just talking about paychecks. Week two of the NFL playoffs kick off today with all eyes on a marquee matchup of AFC quarterbacks.
When you got Lady Gaga tweeting about you, there's some interest beyond sports in this.
Sports Rise, presented by Sloan Toyota.
Hey there, everybody. Welcome into our studios here at Comcast Sportsnet. Thanks so much for spending a part of your Saturday with us. I'm Lisa Hillary. We begin in the association, and the Sixers had Spencer Hawes back in their lineup last night. This after he was believed to be missing yet another game due to lower back pain. But no, this is not the case. Hawes, there he is in the starting lineup after missing a game with that sore back. Maybe he should ask this guy for some advice. Wow, that's impressive. To the game, Wizards got off to a hot start thanks to Nick Young. Drains a jumper. He had 9 in the first. Wizards are up 4, but the Sixers step up the D. Elton Brand gets the steal, and he's out on the break. Hits the layup. Sixers, they're out in front. Then here, off the miss, Iguodala gets the rebound, and the Sixers are on the run yet again. To Jody Meeks, he tied a career high with 26. It's an 8-0 run. Washington just can't keep up with the fast pace. Lou Williams lobbed Iguodala, and you got the feeling where this was going, folks. Let's go to the second quarter. Jrue Holiday, great crossover, and a nice finish with the left. Sixers, they're up 12. Time winding down in the half. Williams has made this an art form. Pumps, draws the foul, and hits the jumper. He would complete the three-point play. Sixers up 14 at the half. Third quarter we go. Hawes with the ball. The back looking fine. Gets his own rebound and put back. Draws the foul. Evan Turner showing the love. 63-44 Sixers. More defense here. Sixers force Washington into 19 turnovers. Iguodala steals and throws it down at the other end. Lead now with 21. One more time from Spencer Hawes. The layup and the foul. Hawes another double-double, part of a 22-4 run. They led by 34 at one point. Sixers all fired up as they beat the Washington Wizards 120-89. Dee Lynam has inside access from the locker room.
Washington came into this game with the worst record in the NBA, and they were scoring the fewest points in the league as well. The Sixers used a 38-18 third quarter to blow this game wide open. All five starters finished in double figures, as did two reserves, and the Sixers scored 36 points off turnovers. It all equaled a 120-89 win.
We felt like we had them on the ropes in the first half, and it's been something we've been doing all year, is coming out in the third quarter and really stretching the lead out. So tonight, I think we had them on the ropes in the first half, and that third quarter was some of the best basketball we played all year, offensively, defensively. It was just clicking.
Yeah, well, we try not to, get into a hole or, play down in the first half, but if that happens, we usually come out second half pretty well. Can't rely on that all the time, but, so far we are.
It's a little surreal right now. We're not taking the highs too high. We know there'll be some lows and some lulls. So, we're just playing every game, coming out trying to compete. And we know as fast as we started, it could go the other way. So we're staying focused and trying to win every ball game.
Jody Meeks finished with a career-high 26 points. He missed just one shot all night long. He was 6 of 7 from 3, 10 of 11 for the game. His night actually began with a very important conversation with his coach.
He just came in to me today. He's the most polite young guy. And he says, Coach, am I doing all right? I only played a few minutes the other night, and in the first half, was I doing anything wrong? And I said, no. You weren't doing anything wrong. I said, New York was big and physical. I thought we need another ball handle on the perimeter, but just be ready.
I wanted to go in and, ask him if I had done anything wrong. He said, no, definitely, definitely not. He just said, it was different matchups that he felt like, we're on the court that were good, and I was fine with that. I just wanted to go in and make sure, and Felt like, you know, I should go in and talk to him and have open dialogue with him.
Meek said after the game that there was good karma in the air for him tonight. It was the anniversary of his 54-point game when he played at Kentucky. The Sixers stay undefeated at home and now head to Washington for the back end of a home and home. In the Sixers locker room, Dee Lynam, CSNPhilly.com.
Yes, as Dee mentioned, Sixers hoping for another blowout at the Wizards' expense tonight in the district. Game time, 7 o'clock. We'll get you ready on Sixers pregame live at 6:30 with reaction and analysis on postgame live once the clock hits zero. Still in the association, Bulls and Celtics in Boston. Derrick Rose back in the lineup after missing a game with a toe injury. Before the half, Rose on the break, pass batted back to him, finishes with the slam just like he drew it up. Bulls are up 19 at the half. Fourth quarter, Celtics get as close as one, but with a three-point lead, Rose wide open, hits from deep, stretches the lead back to six. Just over 2 minutes to play, Rose to the basket. Acrobatic move, he gets it to go. Rose scores 14 points in the fourth, 25 in all. The Bulls, they pull away to win 88-79. Chicago 11-2 is their best start in 15 years. To the ice now. It was supposed to be all about Ilya Brizgalov this season, but lately it's been the Bob Show. Sergei Bobrovsky keeps stealing the spotlight, so much so that he started the Winter Classic and is in the top half of league goalies in both save percentage and goals against average. Bobrovsky has won 5 of his last 6 starts overall, and he is now on a 5-game winning streak away from the Wells Fargo Center. He allowed just 3 goals combined in back-to-back wins over the Hurricanes and the Islanders. Bob has not given up more than 3 goals since November the 19th. Bobrovsky hasn't had nearly as much work as Briz, but his overall numbers are far superior. Here they are. Bob is in the top 17 in the league in goals against average and save percentage, while Brizgalov ranks roughly 40th in both of those categories. Brizgalov does have 16 wins, but his salary more than 10 times that of Bob's. With more on the goalie situation and a look ahead for the Flyers, here's John Borick and Rick Tockett.
Well, the Flyers leave Long Island.